In this video, we are going to talk about elements of visual perception. Now, even if digital image processing is built on the foundation of mathematics, but how humans perceive images plays a very important role in analyzing those images and making the judgment about processing of the image. Hence, it is very important to understand how human visual perception works. So for that, first we will be starting with structure of the human eye. So let us begin. This is basic diagram of human eye, where eye is a near sphere of diameter 20 mm. The front part of eye from where light enters is the cornea. Then there is iris, which actually contracts or expands, so it can vary its diameter. This diameter can vary from 2 to 8 mm. Then the lens in human eye, which is the basic part of the optical system, is made up of concentric layers of fibrous cells with 60 to 70% content of water, and it has more protein than any other cell of the eye. Now, this lens is colored by yellow pigmentation that increases with age, and with age we only call that cataract. Our eye only absorbs 8% of the visible spectrum, which is actually very less, and it can also absorb some part of IR and UV, and that is why our eyes can get damaged if the exposure of light is very high. When light enters eye, it forms real and inverted image on the retina, and retina is filled with the sensors, which are called as rods and cones, and they are all populated in this backside of the eye region. If the ray is entering at 0 degree, it will reach the point which is called as fovea. This fovea is very important. This is the point where most of the cones lie. Cones are responsible for detection of color, and rods are attributed to detection of overall intensity. Let me just write cone over this side so that we can write the properties. Rods are very large in number. There are around 75 to 150 million rods in human eye, as compared to only 6 to 7 millions of rods. 6 to 7 millions of cones. Now here, these are the sensors which are available in human eye in order to detect all the color and intensity. So the rods are distributed at the back of the retina, and cones are mostly concentrated in this fovea region. Here, the entire information is sent to brain via optic nerve, which exit from human eye from this point. That is why at this point there are no sensors, and this point is called as blind spot. Human eye has no sensor in this area, but human brain sort of fills in the information that depending upon the rest of the region, that what will be here. So what we perceive is the combination of image formed on the retina as well as the processing of the brain. It is interesting to see that the size of this fovea is only about size of this fovea is only about 1.5 mm × 1.5 mm. And that is responsible for all the colors that we can sense using our eyes. These rods and cones available in the region of the retina are not evenly distributed. This diagram represents the distribution of rods and cones along the retina. So if you can see here, this is the temple side and this is the nose side. And as the angle is changing, so the central line is zero, where if rays are directly entering into eye, it will reach fovea at 0 degrees. Then as you keep on going towards the higher angle, once towards the nose and once towards the temple. So from this diagram you can see that the number of cones, which is represented by this blue line, are mostly centered at the fovea, and then their number is negligible in the rest of the retina. But the number of rods is more evenly distributed, and it is more at 0 degree, there are only cones and no rods. But as you go away from the center, the number of rods keep on increasing till at least 20 to 30 degree, and then starts to decrease on both sides. But this is the blind spot where neither cones nor rods are there. Also, you can look at the number of receptors per mm square of the area. So it is very high for cones as well as rods. The cones only work during, as you can see, the cones are less in number. They only respond to the well lit conditions of light. So if you have a surrounding which is very dark, then only rods will be activated. For example, if we are observing some colored object in moonlight, you will not be able to see colors, because at that time only rods will become active. So if the light is less, rods are activated. Only if it's a well-lit condition, cones are activated. When cones are active, that kind of vision is called as photopic vision. When rods are activated, that kind of vision is called as scotopic vision or a dim light vision. In cones, again we have three kinds of cones which can differentiate between colors. So that correspond to small wavelength, medium wavelength and large wavelength. And that only we call as, so it is not that eyes are only sensitive for one color, but cones are of three types which are responsible for detection of smaller wavelength, medium wavelength and large wavelength, which will correspond to ultimately the cones which are responsible for detection of smaller wavelength detect blue region, the cones which are responsible for medium wavelength detect green color, and the cones which are responsible for large wavelength correspond to red color. And then mixing all these colors, our eyes are capable of detecting millions of colors at a time. So you can see human visual perception is very rich, and also the range that it carries for adaptation is actually great. About the detection of small, medium and large wavelength of visible range with the help of cone, this diagram will help you understand more. This is the diagram about cone fundamentals, that how you have three kinds of cones in human eye, and the cones which are responsible for detection of smaller wavelength actually correspond to the blue range. So it is not exactly one wavelength that it can detect, but as you can see, blue is ranging somewhere from 400 to 550. So these are three kind of cones. The medium one will cater majorly to green light, but is also capable of detecting blue till some part of red. Then the last one, which is the cones which are responsible for detection of large wavelength, can go practically from slight blue to the entire wavelength, but it peaks somewhere in the region of red. This way, by mixing all these three shades, our eyes can practically detect millions of colors. In a normal camera, we have a fixed focal length, but our human lens is capable of stretching and contracting in order to change its focal length, because we cannot change the distance between a lens and the retina. Now, so as we see, the image is real and inverted. So rest of the processing is done by brain in order to make it erect again. If the distance of this object is increasing, in that case what will happen is, if the object is going farther, then in that case what will happen, this gap will narrow and your image formation distance has to change. If this distance is changing, then as I cannot change this distance, lens contracts and expand in order to change its focal length. So as you know that fatter is the lens, if I have a very fat, if I have a very fat lens, then its focal length would be very small. But if the same lens is made thinner, its focal length will become large. So it will focus at a farther point. Thus, in order to see the nearby object, lens contracts and become fatter. In order to see the objects which are far, it stretches and become thinner. So that's it for elements of visual perception. What we have seen is structure of the human eye. Then we looked at the distribution of rods and cones in the human eye. And lastly, the types of cone which can detect different wavelength of light. And at last, the image formation by human eye. Thank you.